I am Keir Seward, and I am the director of the London segment of Isolation.
Hi, I'm Alex Austin. I'm one of the co-directors on It's Inside and Isolation.
So the film basically revolves around a crazy conspiracy theorist called Paige, who believes that the infectious pandemic that is going on within the film is entirely orchestrated by a weird government conspiracy involving buses and possibly 5G towers and maybe men in invisible suits who are stalking her in her flat. And she goes a bit crazy and does some horrible things in order to try and escape what she perceives of as the people who are trying to get to her.
Yeah. In terms of getting involved in the project, Nathan reached out to us after we premiered on Alta with our short film Wretch, and it kind of went from there, and he introduced us to the concept, and we were like, yeah, sure, we can make that work.
What is the unique appeal and the new challenge of an anthology film as opposed to other forms of cinema?
I think, you know, limited resources with us and it being locked down as well was made it a little bit trickier. But I think in terms of anthology specifically, trying to find a balance between all the different films can be quite a challenge. But I think, you know, we've got a lot of different pacing, which is quite nice.
We kind of like wanted to try and find a way to make our segment as different. And I think that's part of it, is trying to make sure that you stay unique while still sort of like adhering to the, you know, to what the film is about. So we got some gore in there, which is what I really like, you know. So I think, you know, getting some body horror into it was a big thing for us.
Conspiracy theories, particularly about the state of the world, are an increasing part of our life. Does this particular segment of the film have a special comment to make about that in particular?
I mean, I think something that was very important to us was that it didn't end up feeling like we were saying, yes, conspiracies are like valid. We definitely wanted to show that this woman is unfortunately a little bit unstable, and that everything that's happening in the world is really traumatizing. So, you know, it's understandable that she's having a bit of a breakdown. But ultimately, it was more about that descent into madness for us, rather than making a comment on conspiracy theories themselves.
To me, I think it was really big to sort of show how kind of like you can go down a kind of rabbit hole with conspiracy theories, and they can start to become kind of meaningless in so many ways, where, you know, they bleed into each other and they can really sort of like, I mean, I think it's very easy. I don't want to spoil the film, but when you watch our segment, you can kind of, I think, get where we think kind of like getting too far down the rabbit hole in conspiracy theories can kind of lead to.
We're here at Fright Fest celebrating the horror genre. What do you think horror gives both storytellers and an audience that they perhaps don't get from other forms of cinema?
I would say in general, my big word would be catharsis. I think horror a lot of the time is about catharsis, and we do a lot of body horror in particular, but I think that combined experience and really like quite human at its foundation, like human experience and the way that that links up with moments that we've all experienced, can lead to just that release that I think everyone's been looking for, especially at the moment.